So we've discussed the Whitmore Reliability Products Air Sentry and the OilSafe systems. We'd like to have a little bit of a conversation about the application of those products in a real world environment. So today we're visiting a power plant in central Indiana. And to my right, I have Bill, the senior engineering technician of the plant. And to my left, I have Jake Giles of KM Specialty Systems, a Whitmore business and distribution partner for over 30 years. So Bill, if you would, kind of give us a little recap of what was the current state of your lubricant handling program and how you decided there were better practices that could be implemented and the benefit of those and how you discovered and built the program with the assistance of Jake.
Bob, several years ago, our lube program was a mess. You know, back years ago, everything was on a time-based oil change. Sometimes you changed oil when it needed to be. Sometimes it didn't get changed when it needed to be. Through various training classes and courses and magazines and things, we kind of looked at the oil safe system here like we have behind us, and we decided that was the best way to use our oil, use it wisely. We do it on a analysis basis now. Mm-hmm. Instead of somebody getting 5 gallon oil, they can come over and get a gallon. They can come over mm-hmm. and get a quart, you know, whatever they need. And it's constantly filtered. As you can see there on some mm-hmm. of the others, there's drums that come in. It's filtered when it goes in. It's filtered when it comes out.
If I could interrupt, that's an interesting point because I'm assuming that as you were looking for the equipment that would help you establish an oil cleanliness program and a matrix for applying those products to the right critical assets, there's a number of different brands, but what makes the OilSafe system is unique is there's a three-way filtration, right?
Right.
We're filtering the oil as we're transferring it out of the OEM refinery drum into our holding system. While the product is stored in the system, we can energize the system and create a kidney loop, further filtering that oil and conditioning it, as well as when we do our final dispensing into the transfer containers, we're also filtering that oil. So that has a major impact on the cleanliness of the oil before you ever even get it into the asset.
And if you've got older equipment like we do have here, that is a major asset to any kind of older gearboxes, bearings, or anything like mm-hmm. that. And through this whole process, through some of the shows, I've got acquainted with Jake Giles from K&M, and he has really kind of guided us through some of the major steps we needed. So Jake.
We got introduced whenever Bill went to a reliability show, met with some of the Whitmore individuals there, and was going over OilSafe and some of the other products. And being an area distributor for Whitmore products, OilSafe, Air Sentry, JetLube, that stuff. Got the phone call come out, met with Mr. Bill, his counterpart out here at the plant, and it's not a one-size, fits all. This is a customizable system. So we went through quantity of jugs they need, size of system, what their processes were, what the things that could be changed, could be done better, and mm-hmm. How myself at KM and Whitmore could help as a whole. So
well, that's a really critical part of helping the customer identify his needs. So to be a part of that process is absolutely a benefit to you guys. You also play a critical role in that, we have consumable products here, So we've got the oil filters, we've got the desiccant breathers that are trapping the moisture. These things are being consumed, as well as even the jugs. So the next role that you play is that follow-up of having the inventory of those products.
Exactly right. Mm-hmm. I play that follow-up, and then I also play that I'm the face or the go-to initially whenever Bill or his counterpart here, hey, the desiccant breather, the Air Sentry desiccant breather on top of this thing changed colors. I think I know what that means, but what's that mean? I can take them through the whole process of what that is, make sure we're changing stuff accordingly how we should.
It's the understanding the use of the components, but it's also the supply of the consumable components and maintenance and repair.
Yeah.
So, it's basically a one-shot stop for you guys.
And the serviceability from K&M, Jake. And I know there's times Jake probably got, if he looked at my phone number when I called him, it's like, oh, man, what's they want? But no, the service is great. The service is excellent. We've, the years that I've been down at this particular plant, and you know, you talk to a lot of vendors, you talk to a lot, but they back up what they sell. I mean, mm-hmm. they're always there. They're always there for questions. Anytime, you know, you need them.
And things change through the plant.
And things change.
Yeah, so your needs are constantly changing. And, so Jake's here to help you identify these
new. And if there's anything new comes up in the industry, on his end, you know, he's always,
we're constantly having conversations back and forth of, you know, hey, have you seen the latest and greatest that has just mm-hmm. come out? Or have you seen, you know, this new product line? And we have stuff that, you know, Bill comes to me and says, hey, I heard about or I've read about or I've seen this. Is that really all it's you know,
tell
supposed
you
to
know.
Be? Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell me what you know.
So and, it's really a partnership.
It is. Partnership.
You know,
it is.
That's really awesome. So you've gone through the process. You've identified your needs. You've identified the systems and the systems provider to help you through this process. In the final analysis, Bill, you made a pretty significant investment to proposed a pretty significant investment to senior management.
Right.
And they were surely looking for a return on that investment.
Yes.
So what do you think? Best guess. What do you think of that return from the point of actually getting the system up and running and where you saw the return of the system?
I'd say from start to finish, you're looking at a year and a half. We have had this system, I think it's going on 6 years now total, and I can show you the numbers if need be, where this particular system and what we're doing has saved us over $2 million in cost.
Over that 6 years.
Over that 6 years. But yes, the initial investment we got back, our ROT was probably a year and a half.
That's awesome.
It's a great system. It's a good system. It works excellent for us, especially with the older equipment, with your clean oils.
I was going to ask you that. You know, you've identified that just through your product management, you've been able to reduce inventory costs, product handling costs. How's it impacted the equipment? Are you seeing greater equipment service life?
Yes. You know, we've got several pumps and motors and things that we take care of as lubrication engineers on our routes that mm-hmm. Junior and I take care of. There was instances where we was having issues with pumps in some of our condenser pits and things. We was going through those two or three pumps a year. We haven't replaced one in 4 years at
wow.
this point. And that's on the greasing side of it, on the oil side of it. Some of this stuff's going, you know, 4 or 5 years that we've seen since we've done this.
That's awesome.
The oil consumption through oil analysis, you know, if it needs changed, we're going to tell you when it needs changed.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, you run your piece of equipment because we know it's doing what it's supposed to be doing.
That's awesome. I think that's a great testimony, and thank you for taking time, for allowing us to share a little bit of this case history, if you will. Thank you very much on the behalf of Whitmore, the power plant, for allowing us to come and look at their facility. And thank you, Jake, for all the important role that you've played in this
Definitely.
Process. Awesome.
Definitely.
Great partnership. Thank you, Bill.
Thanks, Bob.